Hello. I bought several of the network modules you see here. I had a lot of trouble with them, but developed a solution. Hopefully, what I've done will be of some help to you. These devices are Ethernet connected relay controllers from China, sometimes called network modules. The ones I have are marked Web Relay Con version 2.0 HW-584, as you can see in the picture. The prior version, marked as version V.1 FC-160, had issues, and I was hoping the version 2.0 would have those issues fixed, but the issues are still present. In general, the problem with these devices as received from the factory are that all of the devices have the same MAC address, and there's no means to give each one a unique MAC address. The impact is that you can only have one device on any given network. Further, if you change the IP address, a power outage will cause the device to go back to its factory default IP address. In fact, if you have a power loss, the device forgets all the settings and relay states you put into it. And even though the original device information indicates that you can change the device port number, you aren't really changing a port number. You're only changing a directory reference. The device actually only uses port 80, and again, you can't change it. I needed to use these devices and decided to write my own code for them to fix the issues and add features. All of the source code, documentation, and a downloadable binary image is available for free on GitHub. The documentation included with the project shows how to download the new code image and program it into your network module. In this video, I'll bypass that process of reprogramming the module and just demonstrate what you'll get if you do reprogram it. This is a network module that I just programmed. It's attached to 16 relays. Let me go ahead and turn it on. You see that the network module turned on, but also all the relays turned on. I'll get to that in just a second. When you first connect with the device on its default IP address of 192.168.1.4, port 8080, you'll see this screen. I usually only attach 1 to 4 relays to a network module on my application, but I've attached 16 relays on my test bench for the demo. So the first thing I think I'll show is that the code includes the ability to invert the relay control outputs. That's this setting here. I'll go ahead and turn the inversion on and I'll save it. Now you note that all the relays are off to match the settings that you see on the screen. This enables you to adapt very easily to whatever type of relays you bought, whether they're active high or active low control inputs. You can change the default name of this particular relay module. This is the default name. This is only to help you identify where the device is located when you log into it. This helps if you have several on your network. You can turn relays on and off with radio buttons. Like so. And notice I'm turning them on and off here, but nothing's happening on the relay module itself. The changes take effect when you press the save button. You could click on the undo all button to undo the things you just put in before you save it, but I'll go ahead and save it and you'll see the changes on the relay module. Once you've saved any changes, the network module will retain the settings through a power outage. Now let's change some of the device address settings. Here you can change the IP address. I'll change it to 183 just for demonstration. You can change the gateway should you choose to. Change the netmask. You can change the port number. Just for demo, we'll change it to 8081. And you can also change the MAC address. And again, just for demo, I want to change this to an FF. Oops. And again, you can click undo to undo everything you just did, or you can click save, and it will make the changes to the network module. Now, of course, because I changed NetMask and the IP address, we're not going to be able to find the device until I put in the new IP address for it and the port number. And we selected port. There we go. So now we can see the device. And if I hop back over to address settings, you can see that our changes took effect. Once again, these are saved and they will survive a power cycle. Just a comment. Many people think that the MAC addresses are all assigned by an international authority. And this is generally true for commercially available equipment, so that you don't end up with any duplicate MAC addresses on your network. But the MAC address definitions also allow for locally administered addresses, addresses you can assign on your own network. The documentation explains all of this, but you should be safe if you leave the C2 part of the MAC address, this first octet, just leave that alone, and you can change any of the rest of these to anything you want. But you should keep track of them on your own network so you don't inadvertently give two devices the same MAC address. By the way, if you make a mistake in any of this stuff and can no longer contact the network module, all you have to do is press the reset button. I'll point to it here. It's right next to the LED. Hold it down for about 10 seconds and you'll see the LED go out. When you release the button, the module will return to its default settings. I did add a couple of help pages. These really just show you, for instance, the REST commands that you could use. These are commands you can just send in an HTTP form to turn relays on and off or to perform other functions. Kind of useful. They're fully explained in the documentation. There's also just a help page that shows you what the default settings are for the device. One other interesting page is network statistics. If you click on that, you'll get a listing of what's going on your network that this device can see. All of the dropped and received packets, these numbers will get quite large because the device is looking at all packets that are presented to it, rejecting most of them because they're not addressed to this device. You'll also see things like the ICMP packet count go up should you ping the device. You'll see counts of the packets that are sent and received as part of the process of setting and clearing relays. In general, the other counts that are in here, at least I never see them change. I suppose they would be changing if you had some pretty significant network error activity occurring. The network statistics page is useful for diagnosing network problems and for making sure that the device is working smoothly. Note that this page does not update dynamically. It takes a snapshot when you access the page, and it will update with new counts the next time you access the page. Let's go back to the relay controls. Now I'm going to type in a couple of those REST commands that I referred to, show you how they work. So I can go up to the address bar, and for instance, if I put in a 00, whoops, I'm going to go all the way back, put in 00, and click on it. Notice relay 1 turned off. If I now put a 01 in, notice that relay 1 turned on, both on the screen and the relay itself. You can do that with any individual relay, turning them on and off. You can also turn them all on or turn them all off as follows. If I put in 55, they all turn on. Put in 56. They all turn off. One other command that will be useful. 99. It takes you to a page that shows a simplified presentation of the relay states. They were all off, so I've got all zeros here. But they would start with relay 1 at the left side and relay 16 at the right side being set to 1 if the relay was on. If you're writing an app, you can use this command to obtain a simplified form of the relay states. Now if I put in this command, it's going to get me back to displaying. Oops. Fat fingering the keyboard here. There we go. To displaying the relay control page. And that's it for the demonstration. Again, the project can be found on GitHub. The documentation there illustrates what you need to download and program the code into your network module. While the documentation explains how to do this reprogramming, I'll work on another YouTube video to demonstrate reprogramming. In the meantime, my project email address is in the documentation on the GitHub site if you want some help with this. Thanks for watching. Hope this helps you with your home automation projects.